Welcome to the Enquendo Guitars Workshop. Guitar making often requires specialized tools, which are quite expensive because they're specialized tools. And that's why I like to make them myself. And today I want to show you how I make my Radius sanding blocks. Please let me know in the comments section down below if you also make your own tools and what tools you make and on what projects you use them. Well now, let me take off my vest and let's get started. While cleaning up my shop this week, I found this big piece of hardwood. I don't know what species it is, but it's perfect to make a radius sanding block. But first things first, let's figure out the length I want and make sure this piece of stock is nice and square. To make it easier to keep the radius in your fretboard as level as possible while sanding it, I think it's a good option to have a very long radius sanding block. So that's what we're going to make. We're going to make it extra long, so I'm able to sand the radius into the fretboard with the fretboard touching the sanding block at all points at all times. In order to determine the length, I'm going to simulate the sanding motion and mark out the required length. So somewhere probably around here. Let's measure it out. Somewhere around 75 centimeters. So I'm going to make mine 75 centimeters long. Now let's cut it to length. Yeah, now that it's cut to length, it's time to make sure it's all nice and straight and level and all square. I'm going to use my hand planes. What I like to do if I need to square up a piece of stock like this, or a neck blank for example, I like to find the side which is, or the corner which is most square to start off from as a reference. Very close. This is the corner that is most square, so I'm going to use this as a base reference to square up the rest of the stock. With the blank prepared, it's straight and level and squared up. I like to draw in a center line as a point of reference. In order to get the radius into your sanding block, you're gonna need some kind of a jig. I made mine a couple of years ago, so unfortunately I don't have a video of me making this jig, but let me run you through some of the features. I've based my jig on this Dremel Trio router. I don't think they make them anymore, but it's a very nice small little router. It's very lightweight and very silent, and it's specially suited for these small jobs. Your jig needs to have some kind of pendulum that allows for the swinging motion, so you get the radius you need in your sanding block. Mine is set up at the moment to make a 12 inch radius. 12 inches is 304.8 millimeters. So that's 12 inches from the tip of the router bit up to the pivot point. I made my jig so I can set it up for multiple radii.
Yeah, and at the back. At the back I've got some height adjustment, so I can raise or lower the entire pendulum according to the block I'm using to get the depth of cut I want. Yeah, there's a guide rail to guide the block nice and straight through the jig. And of course a center line at the base of the jig to make sure the pendulum is centered to the center of the jig and of course the center of the block. Yeah, that's my jig. If you have any questions about this jig or you want to know more details, please let me know in the comments down below and I will maybe make a separate video on this jig. When working with jigs like this, I like to take the smallest amount off as possible at each swing of the pendulum, just to prevent any excess forces on the router or the jig. I want my end result to be as smooth as possible without any nasty surprises. As you can imagine, with an almost 75 centimeter long sending block, this is going to take a while, so let's put this into a time lapse. I'm done routing. This is what it looks like right now. We've got just a few marks here and there, nothing major. We can easily clean it up with a piece of sandpaper. And let's check the radius. Yeah, nice radius as well. Let's see if we can check it. Check the radius, 12 inch, looks great. Yeah, now the only thing left to do is clean it up, then it's ready to go. To clean up the routing marks, I'm going to use one of these sanding beams. They're perfectly straight and with a fine grit sandpaper I'm just going to remove the marks left by the router. While sanding down the router marks, keep checking with a straight edge if your sanding block stays nice and level. I just finished sanding out all the marks left by the router and now I've got my ultra long sanding beam. Yeah, nice quick little project, took me just under a day to do, and that includes for me setting up the camera and the lighting for each different shot, so I'm sure you can do it much faster. Again, let me know in the comments the tools you've made yourself and the projects you use them on. Yeah, I'm really going to enjoy this one on the next guitar build, which should start maybe coming week. I've ordered some new woods, so the coming video might be a new guitar build. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you in next video. And until then, have a nice week.